The Pom, Martin Potter in red, and Greg Day for Australia wearing the green. The nine flag flies high at Bells Beach, Victoria. Surfer up now is Martin Potter, and this is a good wave too. He comes off the bottom. Look at the suck section as he comes down again and drives up the face, and the Pom gets a good start. Martin Potter on a very colourful surfboard here. A pretty grey and angry sea. Comes back left now. Starts swinging off the top, waiting for the bowl to build up again as the wave flattens out in the rip. And this Bells Beach rip is notorious. Bouncing the board down the face, waiting for it to pick. Now it starts to move. Potter looking pretty relaxed today. Swings off the top, right off the edge, and that's a good wave for Potter. Greg Day, the Australian, now in the green. Trapped in the soup, caught off in the white water, but you can see that he's still looking for that face. He's running the white water, waiting for the build-up. Little swing turn off the top. That wave's been pretty fat. Nice re-entry, though, as he goes back left side. Comes off the top again, so some nice manoeuvres, but not a good scoring wave. Long paddle here. Potter takes off, another nice face to drop down, and beautiful re-entry off the top and makes it two. Well, Potter really is, and a slip. Well, that's unfortunate because he rode so well. By G came off the bottom of that wave very, very well, and he'll have to hurry back to the takeoff area now. The cold face is really eager to watch the action as Potter takes off again, and he's certainly getting the waves to ride. Look at that as he comes back, covered up in the white water. Drives under the white water looking for that green face to work on. There it is. Now he puts the manoeuvres together. Using the ankles, using the arms, the legs to pump away as he swing turns around. Now watch the bowl section. Here it comes. Under the lip he goes. Good power. Nice turn off the top. Plenty of speed. And again. Comes off again, but he would have scored well. That's two falls that he's had, but that one's right on the edge. He's certainly scoring high. Now that's the paddle out at Bells Beach. I mean, from the shore break right out to where Greg Day is sitting is around about 300 metres. Now, remember, they've got to do it four, five, maybe six times in a heat. You've got to be pretty fit. Greg Day from Australia. This is a better wave for Day now. He's got a bit of face to work on as he comes off the top and heads out on that shoulder. Swing turns. Hasn't got quite the confidence of Potter. Looking a little ragged, Day. Pretty hard place to surf this. Bitterly cold in the water. There's a lot of chop on the face, and that white water really does punch at you when it hits you. But that's a nice re-entry. That's a backside one, one that he'd rather not have done, I think. Martin Potter coming out after that heat. Makes his way back to the pavilion. As Tommy Curran from the USA takes off. Backside at Bells. Smaller wave. Again, that action of pumping the wave face, trying to get the board to run as he goes left, waiting for the build-up now. Tommy Curran from the United States, one of the real hot kids. Hits the shoulder now as it bowls up for him. See how the boards just accelerate. Once that wave starts to hollow out, the boards really start to move. They're only short. Look at the power of that shore break as he came down. Now that's the priority buoy that Mike Zambrisi is going round, also from the United States. That means that once he's turned that buoy, Tommy Curran really can't take the wave. The Victorian Lifesavers are here too. They've been making sure that nobody gets into trouble as Zambrisi takes the drop at Bells Beach. Off the shoulder, this is a nice wave. Comes back in the curl, hits the lip again. That priority buoy is really important, because it does give them the edge. It means that they've got the choice of the wave that they want. Now, if they go for that wave and miss it, then the other surfer can take it. Zambrisi scoring good points here. This is a good wave. You can see that the power is there. Colourful wetsuits, of course. There's a little bit of psychology there, too, to catch the judge's eyes. Long paddle back out at Bells Beach, and you can see that wind really flattening off the top of the ocean. When you get out to the takeoff area, it's waves like this that surfers come right around the world to surf. They're big, they're strong, they're powerful. It's Curran, hits the top and takes the drop. Handling the white water very well, Tommy Curran. His father was one of the best big wave riders ever to come out of Hawaii. this kid's got plenty of ticker, let me tell you. Size doesn't worry him. He's not all that big. He's got a big heart. Thumping it down at the shore break, waiting for the run. Swinging the body around, getting the turns, amassing the points now. This beats some of the action.